the foundation to commemorate the Chinese railroad work in Canada. Mr. Wu, please.
Carson Low, National Chair Richard Wong, Sean Chen, the MP, and also the Chinese. Thank you very much for inviting me to come to this meeting, this conference. And I would like to welcome all the friends from Vancouver. I was surprised that so many of them. Can you just go ahead? How many of you from Vancouver? Thank you very much for all coming, especially the 94 years old Mr. Tom Huang. Thank you. I would like to welcome you all to come to Toronto, and myself, I belong to the foundation to commemorate the Chinese Railroad work in Canada. Our foundation started in 1984, and our mandate is to promote the awareness of Chinese Railroad work in Canada, and we also try to help the other non-profit organizations, like Canada, 150 funding organization, and also we do have scholarship for the student that will write essays every year to write about Canada, write about Chinese Canadian, how they contribute to the Canada, for especially the Chinese global worker. To echo Mr. Qing Ying about what when the first Chinese arrived, yes, 1788, the first fur trade time that people come to here to do a carpentry, and they also do the smith to help to the different trade in Canada. So since 1788, we have been contributing our talent to this country already. In 1881 to 1884, during those times, the Pacific Railroad, they want to build a railroad, and they try to hire local people. There's only about 400 people show up. Then they don't have enough, they need at least 10,000. So they recruit overseas from China. So there were over 17,000 Chinese came over to contribute. And they helped to build the railroad from coast to coast. But they are doing the most dangerous job. The most dangerous job that the other people don't want to do. So a lot of them sacrifice their life to this country. At least over 4,000 of them sacrifice their life during those time of building the railroad. So, but after they build the railroad, the government say, okay, well, we don't need you anymore. So from 1923 to 1947, they have an earthquake. Rule: no more Chinese ship allowed to come to this country. So, but what's very nice is that all the veterans that the Chinese Canadian, they joined the war. They said, "We are Canadian. We contribute to the country to fight." So I would like to thank all the veterans. So after that, in 1967, then they have this universal immigration policy, so they welcome everybody from all over the world to come to this country. So we have a country from all origins and contribute our best to this country. And we want to drum and let people know that we are here. We are here to contribute. So I really thank again for your time the Chinese rail worker, they think of the east, and west coast together. So the country are united, with the economically, politically, that we are all have this linkage, united, then we can really do a lot of things together. So nevertheless, our Chinese have been contributing in different fields, like we have in different kind of business. And so I'm so happy that we are doing Canada 150 on July the 1st, 2 p.m. We all jump together. Like in China, we're trying to put one bell, one roll. I think we have one drum, one country, one world.